This is your time. The answer to what is happening to you is here. You five are the Power Rangers.
Hi, welcome back to Fakko, where, you know, we review movies that you may or may not have watched, and we may or may not have watched as well. This week, we'll be starting with Power Rangers.
Yes, Power Rangers is an American superhero movie. I mean, everybody has heard about Power Rangers, especially if you have kids or you were kids. You were a kid. Once upon a time, yes, you would definitely know who the Power Rangers are.
Because you'd have to be a kid.
Yeah. So this one is the first big screen reboot proper with some money.
Right.
Okay. Thrown in. There are no scenes where Caucasian actors are acting on one hand, and when they fight, the scenes are cut.
The original Japanese
Power Rangers fighting, doing kung fu kicks and jumping around. So this is a proper big budget movie directed by this guy Dean Israelite. He was known for another movie which involves sort of teenagers as well, Project Almanac, if you remember.
Yep.
The time travel.
Yep. Which I did not watch.
I watched that movie. So, well, backstory, it's five kids who end up becoming Power Rangers. Then there were monsters and robots fighting each other.
Yep.
And the Power Rangers save the world.
Yes.
Yeah. I kind of enjoyed the movie whilst I was watching it. My kids, who are teenagers, also enjoyed the movie very much. Because I think the difference between this movie and the TV series is that A, they actually took the trouble to write the decent script, right, a decent backstory. They tried to cover all different types of kids.
Yeah.
It goes, this Chinese kid, and who actually can act, and who actually, unlike the Kong Chinese chick who couldn't act, this one can act. There's a black kid who is sort of having some sort of disability.
No, yeah, he's on the autism spectrum.
Yeah.
Yep.
There is the white Caucasian kid who is the leader, of course. There is a Hispanic girl.
Yeah.
Who is also this? Her sexual preference is dubious.
Who may or may not be non-binary in her gender preference.
I think there is also the cheerleader.
Yes.
She's the hot one.
Yes.
And the Miss Popular.
Yes.
So I mean, it's half of the movie went through this journey of self-discovery, knowing who you are, all kinds of those bits, right? I mean, the actors are unknown. I mean, I've never seen them anywhere before. The lead actor looks like, what's his name, the High School Musical guy.
Oh, Zac Efron.
Zac Efron. Otherwise, I suppose, yeah, half the movie about self-discovery.
Well, okay.
Nice backstory, a bit of drama, a bit of love interest here and there. Issues that teenagers go through.
Yeah, well, it's fairly straightforward in that sense. Yeah, I mean, it should be noted there was that Mighty Morphin Power Rangers was made, I think, about 10 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Right, and that was banned from here because it had the word morphine in it.
Yeah.
Right? So there is that. So
that wasn't really a big budget one, though.
Yeah. But it didn't matter because none of us watched it because, you know, otherwise we'd be more fiend up or something like that. Yes. So anyway, in this one, yeah, you're right. It's a fairly straightforward movie that it's designed to appeal to the kids and the teenagers. So the plot, the narrative is fairly straightforward. Yeah, a bunch of misfits, or, you know, even the cheerleader has her issues.
Yeah.
You know, so she's not like, you know, yeah. So everyone has a heart of gold inside, obviously, somewhere.
Everybody had issues.
Yeah, everyone had issues.
And they covered every conceivable teenage issues out there.
Yeah, so they're sort of all misfits who get together and then, you know, sometimes they don't get along and then, you know, it's the usual stuff. Except this one, because it's not a romantic comedy thing, so you know the boy doesn't get the girl because you know that's not what this movie is about, right?
Oranges don't drag each other.
Not yet, anyway. Well, at least not in public. Yeah. You know, they might be bonking, you know, non-stop behind the scenes. You never know. But that's beside the point. So the thing is, So it's straightforward in that sense, and for that, because you know what you're going to get, and you know there's going to be a monster somewhere in the middle towards the end, and you know they should win, and you know they have, because it is Power Rangers, so we should know them to, we should expect them to then combine and make that Megazord thing.
Yeah.
That has to come somewhere.
Yeah.
So, you know, in that sense, actually no surprises, and all the better for it.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of monster movies, it's not as good as, say, for example, Godzilla.
Right?
But in terms of monster and robot movie, it's not as bad as a Transformer movie. I mean, for me, it's not as bad as that. There's no leery cameras. It's a kids. Kid-friendly movie.
Yeah, because I think they had that in spirit, right? So that's why when even in the fight scenes, it's like the series itself. You know, the weird kung fu and people jumping around and then
no one dies.
Yeah, yeah. And then to sort of, and then even the monster, you know, the rock monster thing. You know, it's just like the series itself. Not that I watched a lot of it, but the bits that I watch, you're right, where sometimes in order to save money, even in the series, then the fight scenes, they cut back to the original Japanese one, right? Yeah. I used to get slightly confused because, you know, they'd do something, blah, 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 that'd be like American kids. And then suddenly the hue and the saturation of the film
completely changes.
Yes, and I'm like, it's not the same, is it? You know, but in this case, it is the same, but it does look as corny and as cack as the original.
Yeah.
Even how they fight.
It's done on purpose. I hope it's done on purpose.
Yeah, it has to be.
That element of corniness is still there.
Yeah.
Elizabeth Banks' ex is the baddie.
Yeah.
And she goes over the top, completely over the top with it. And I think that's how the baddies in Power Rangers, there's no grey, it's either black or white. Right?
There are hints of greener, but yeah, otherwise, yeah. But yeah, and I mean, at least it did not go through the, you know, let's do a gritty reboot type thing.
There was a bit of grit when the sexuality was a bit.
Oh yeah, yeah, but it was touched on extremely briefly.
Yeah.
You know, but and otherwise no, there's no grit in it. It didn't, you know, the night scenes are not dark. You know, it's not fucking Batman, basically.
Yeah, it's not.
So you know, so that's a great thing about it, and I really really enjoyed that.
Yeah.
You know, because I must say, you know, I mean, we're probably going to review something else after this, which is completely the opposite of this. Oh. But for what it's worth, for this, I found it extremely enjoyable.
Yeah, for the 2 hours or so in the cinema, you are gripped, you laugh at the right spots, and you know it's an enjoyable movie.
Yeah.
The kids will enjoy it, and in fact, it reminded me of the other movie where a bunch of teenagers got superpowers, and it was a found footage.
Chronicles.
Yeah. So it reminded me of that movie.
Yeah, but Chronicle was grittier.
Gritty. Yeah. But the bit that I liked was that, I mean, if you were a kid and you get superpowers, you do the same thing, right? You go and beat up the guy who bullies you, you know? Like that, you do it. So, yeah, all in all, I enjoyed it. I would give it, I think it's a 3-star movie.
I think it's a 3-star movie. It's not going to win any awards, but it will also not suffer too badly from rewatching.
Yeah. So if you've got kids, you need them to be quiet for about 2 hours. Yeah, just put it on or take them for it, and they will be glued and they will watch it. And worst case scenario, they'll just ask you to buy the Power Ranger toys.
Yeah, and the Megazord. The Megazord is not bad. It's actually quite good.
Okay.
That's it.